Join me on this journey of canine discovery as I return to Ghana to explore its growing dog culture. Ghana is a beautiful and thriving country with a very welcoming atmosphere. The purpose of this video is to give you guys a good insight to the growing pet culture in Ghana and what I love to do when I visit. For those who don't know, my name is Caesar. I've been involved in the breeding and the training of working dogs for over 10 years. Alright then, well, I've had my smoothie, let's go check out these pet shops.
Yeah, Village Pet is an ultra-modern pet shop. We've been in business for over 20 years now. Here at Village Pet, we stock pet accessories, we stock everything that your pet needs. This is a total pet shop. We don't only deal in dogs, we deal in every pet that you can think of, birds, fishes, rabbits, and everything, all accessories that you need. And then we also stock the wildlife as well. We have a small petting area where you can bring kids for excursions, for educational tour. Yeah, so you can locate Village Pet at Jolu, Last Chance area, and then we can be reached on 0244-062-796 and then 020-815-4159. Some of the pets that you can find in Village Pet are, we have domestic rabbits, we have monkeys, we have different birds, different kinds of parrots, we have fishes, kois, different types of fishes, accessories and everything. Tortoise, peacocks, and any pet that you can think of.
It's clear to see that in Ghana the pet culture is a strong and growing one. I guess it's safe to say that it's all about their pets living their best lives. Believe it or not, on my many visits to Ghana, I've never ever actually stepped foot in a pet shop, but I would say on this occasion, I was pleasantly surprised by the quality and the array of products that I had available. So here I am at Ghana Military Police's canine training grounds. Every time I come here, I have to visit. I love it. I think it's the best example of having a secluded area to train in, but also has the environmental noise of the urban environment. These grounds were built back in the early 90s under the rule of President Rawlings, who's legendary in Ghana history. He clearly understood the need of having working canines as part of the military. Taking into consideration that these kennels are over 20 years old, they've held up exceptionally well. The dogs are well looked after, healthy, full of beans, It goes without saying that clearly here, canine welfare is of high importance.
Here I am with Colonel Gobunu today at Ghana Military Training Academy, based in Accra. The main objective of today's exercise is to enhance the current detection levels of the puppies they have coming through. It's very key for us to not only source good quality genetics, but also to be able to continue their training in this environment, which obviously has a different humidity than other continents on the globe.
Start a search around a certain area, which is called a search wall. This is the first stage where we try to let the dog know exactly what he's doing. Wearing this on the dog, for the dog to understand that yes, work is really about to start. So we are about to set up.
This is very, very important. You'll know when it comes, with warning and without any warning. The atomic bomb. Nuclear energy.
Another important factor has been raised by Colonel Kobunu is the need to start breeding dogs of this climate so as to genetically enforce the fact that their nose and scent capacity is for the environment they're born in. Importing dogs from other countries are a good short-term resolution, but really long-term, you want to have your own stock that is genetically suitable for the environment it's in.
Nuclear energy. We must be ready for a new danger, and this is very, very important. You'll know when it comes, with warning and without any warning. The atomic bomb.
Obedience is something that I truly encourage in all training sessions. Remember, power without focus is useless. Grips or bite development is all about limiting risk for the canine whilst encouraging maximum bite force and stopping power. Remember to always keep your eye on the ball, keep an eye on the dog. I've always been a firm believer of training for real life situations, hence why I think it's very important for dogs to always be aware of their handler's zone and location.
I haven't done nothing. Okay, I haven't done anything. Okay. Hey!
All right. Well, this Mally doesn't seem to like to out, so I thought let's play the redirection game, and he seems to be a pro. The man beside me is Ahmed von Kaps, the president of Ghana's German Shepherd Society, as we walk in to an interview regarding the decoy seminar we're holding.
You know that there's some good news coming up shortly. Yeah, good news coming up shortly. I'm sure you heard about the much awaited talk with the Ghana-born British-based dog trainer. Don Caesar. A lot of people will call it as Don Caesar, since it's still close to the radio, tuning in and you hear. Alright? Ghana-born British-based, Don Caesar is actually Ghana-born British-based dog trainer with over 10 years experience, specializing in the training and breeding of working dogs. And I mean working dogs, not the Satchi or the Dakara, say. Or Barbina and Wolfman. No. I'm talking about working dogs. Working with the Ministry of Justice in the UK and one of the best in the industry, training provided only to selected clients, as he believes the quality matters, not the quantity. That's right. So I want to welcome Don Caesar live to Radio Gold. Don.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Happy to be here.
That's right. And I also have W.O. Nandra William, also in the building. W.O. Welcome.
Thank you.
That's right. And I have Kenneth Singer also. Kenneth Singer is not a Chinese, so he's also black though.
Kenneth. I'm a Ghanaian.
You're also a Ghanaian.
Thank you very much.
All right, you're welcome.
For instance, if you have a dog that is not trained and you expect that dog to protect or guide you in your house, that dog, for instance, will be like a human being. If it becomes critical, that dog is going to be like safety first. He's going to run. If you have armed robbers break into your house forcefully, that dog is going to run because he's not trained. Just like an ordinary person who is not a military man, when there's coup or there's a gunshot, he's going to run. But a military man, when there's war or something, he wants to even go in there. When he's not even invited, he wants to go in there and see what is happening. Mm. So the same thing happens to dogs in terms of security. But when they go through the training regime, they have that courage to stand every pressure that is coming in.
The most important thing is know when to positively reinforce when the dog reacts to your command. And secondly, people talk to dogs with so many sentences. The truth of the matter is dogs do not understand lengthy sentences.
That's right.
So if it is tnasi, you can just say tna.
Okay.
And confirm when the dog reacts.
Okay.
And the dog will understand that tina means it should sit.
Okay. Few syllables is good for them. That's what it is.
Yes.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
In two scopes. The first level is for the normal individual, Mr. and Mrs. Common person on the road, in the public. Your dog is your family pet, your friend, your consolant, your animal that you can go and tell them all your business and know that nobody's ever going to know. Your source of joy, happiness, and comfort. That's probably the most first basic level. The second level is your protector of your home. Now, being a protector, there's different levels of protection. Just understand, it doesn't necessarily mean that a dog has to protect you while biting someone. That's not always the case. Not everybody needs to get bitten. Sometimes it can only be to alert you of the incident occurring, which gives you time to respond. It could be somebody breaking into your house or somebody at your front door. You just want to know. That's fine. It's okay to have a dog like that. But also the public needs to understand what they're looking for in that dog. I'll be perfectly honest with you. A fully trained protection dog is an investment that I cannot put money on, because what that dog will do for you is it's your life looking after.
If you join us, we are talking to W.O. Nandera from the military service. We have Caesar all the way from the U.K., all dog trainers, and you Kenneth Singer also here. And we are talking about the seminar coming up on Saturday at 2 p.m. at the Trade Fair.
We agreed to start the decoy session with an example of what could potentially happen in the day-to-day lives of any civilian. In this case, a robbery at gunpoint, and how a dog can in effect assist. Dry building is such an art form. Many different decoys have variations of styles in order to get the desired results. My main thing is this: ultimately, you get out of the dog what you put in.
I've always been a firm believer of sharing is caring, and that includes knowledge, especially of dogs. The aim of the Open Day / seminar was to allow the general public and trainers alike, novice to experts, to be able to approach myself and the team and to ask and inquire about those really tough issues that they have. Again, how do we expect to raise the standards if we keep all knowledge to ourselves? It's a collective movement.
By canine crew protection based in the UK has been by far one of the best quality we've had so far. So I'd like to extend my gratitude and thank you, and I encourage everyone out there to do their best to try and contact canine crew for all their protection needs. I mean, ask the corporal himself, what do you think about it?
Yeah, you are so safe when you are wearing it, and basically for irritation, it's a very good bite, and the sheep die. We used to hear the dogs sound very loud and clear. So I think it's a nice product. Maybe it's my first time of seeing this company name crew, Canine Crew.
Yeah. Okay, like I said, good quality. I used it. I guarantee it's better than most. I'm enjoying it. I plan to get more. Thank you very much, Canine Crew.
Okay, guys, thank you for watching my first ever canine documentary. I hope you guys are bite ready.